Does that mean you're not going to hear the law of God?
I'm a man of word.
That's 22 verse 5. Because if this brother is a man, Fatima, stop talking. Let forth the word come forth. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 22 and verse 5. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
One of the laws of God, that if this brother is a God-fearing man, he's going to teach you about what women's supposed to wear. Like this man right here. He is a father. Are you not? That's your daughter, right? When your daughter gets up in age, hold up, sister. I'll let you talk. Now, don't be disrespectful to the word. Listen up, read.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
What is that talking about? Many people say, I don't understand what that means. Let's read on to get a clear understanding. Read.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
I'm gonna use your daughter to explain it. Because I bet you, your daughter has better understanding than most of the adults out here. What's your name, honey? That's a nice name. You are a cute girl. Listen good, sweetie. Read it again.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
So the woman should not wear that which pertains to a man. You might be confused at that statement. What's the next part? Come on.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
How old is your daughter?
Three?
I'm going to use a 4.5-year-old to show that our women and our men don't like God's laws. Sweetheart, my question is, what if daddy wanted to wear a dress? What would you say to daddy if he wanted to put on a dress like a woman would? What do you say to him? Well, come here, mommy. What would you say to daddy?
Take it off.
Oh, hold up now. Wait a minute. Hold up. Say that again.
Take it off.
So now, if a 4.5-year-old has that understanding, why do our people who are 45.5 have a problem with God's law? Read it again. Come on, brother.
Deuteronomy 22. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
Come on.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
Because the sister here, her name was, I forgot her name already. Fatima was here telling us a story about how her great-grandson was in jail and she had things stolen from her. I told her the reason why is because we as a people don't keep God's laws. One of the laws we're bringing forth is this law. Your daughter knows if you came home with a dress, that'd be out of order. Why? Because little girls know mommies and grandmommies wear dresses. Daddies don't wear dresses. But then why do sisters wear pants? See that? Why do we have the bathroom signs? The little girls, if I bring a girl to China, Russia, Iraq, she's going to know where to go to the bathroom. Why? Because she's going to look for the what, Dad? She's going to look for the dress, right? Brother, the Bible's clear. Read it again.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man. Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
And your daughter, God's spirit, is telling this, that's not right. But as she gets older, if you let her go, next thing you know, she'll be wearing pants. Next thing, brother, with all due respect, listen to my words. She might come home and be a lesbian. If you're not teaching her God's laws, she can slip away from this. Give me Deuteronomy 6 verse 5. Well, what's your name, brother?
Pablo.
That's your son?
Prince.
Prince Pablo. What's your name, mommy, again?
Caitlin.
That's your father. Your father needs to come back and learn God's laws. This is what you need to do, Pablo, for your children. Because the churches...
I'm doing it.
Okay, brother. Let's see if you're doing it. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 6 and verse 6.
Wait a minute, hold on. I have to take a step back. Because all due respect, you're not doing it. Because we just read a law, your daughter is wearing, that's not a woman's garment. That's not a child's garment. Doesn't matter. Listen good, brother.
She's a child.
She's a child. Right. You have to teach her. She don't know any better. She have to make sure she wears a dress. Things pertain to a woman. Because she's a young girl who will become a woman.
We are right. Sinners, man.
You're all sinners. So don't we just stay sinners?
Paul
says,
don't.
Oh, wait. Paul, what verse did Paul say? What verse did Paul say we're all sinners stayed away?
I don't know.
You don't know? Give me Romans
2:13. Yeah, Romans.
Let's get to the book of Paul. Paul wrote about that. Brother, I want you to go away knowing they're trying to plant a seed of the laws of God in you. Listen, because if you know,
I'm chosen.
You're chosen.
You are.
Teach your daughter the laws. Teach your son the laws.
We going to throw dragons like this.
Okay.
Dragons.
Okay. How are we going to get there?
Pablo.
All right, brother. Read the scripture. Come on.
Romans chapter 2 and verse 13. For not the hearers of the law are just before God.
Not the hearers of God's law are just before God. Read.
But the doers of the law shall be justified.
So if you don't do God's law, you're not going to get the kingdom of heaven. You're not going to be justified, Pablo. Go back to Romans 20 and verse 13. Romans 20 and verse 13. So our people are without God's laws. Ezekiel 33, the last two verses. It's a sweet sound, and they listen as the people listen. Ezekiel 33, verse 33. So, what are we going over? We're going over the laws of God. What audience are we speaking to? The 12 tribes of the nation of Israel. For too long, our people have learned that they're black men, Hispanic men, Native American Indians. That's not so. You are the 12 tribes of Israel, and you are wicked as hell. Read, come on.
Ezekiel chapter 33 and verse 30. Also, thou son of man, the children of thy people still are talking against thee by the walls.
Read it again, brother.
Also, thou son of man, the children of thy people,
the children of thy people. You black men and black women are the children of God's people. You Hispanic men are the children of God's people. Read.
Still are talking against thee by the walls.
It says still. Back in Babylon, you still ran your mouth. Back in Persia, you still ran your mouth. Back in Dogon, ancient Greece, you Negroes still run your mouth back then. Read, come on.
Still are talking against thee by the walls and in the doors of the houses, and speak one to another, every one to his brother, saying, come, I pray you, and hear what is the word that cometh forth from the Lord.
That's what Fatima does. She says, come, I want to learn the word of the Lord. But when change comes out based upon the law, they go away. The same brother from 1983, he knew as the Israelite. When the laws come forth, when a stir or stand man comes forth, he flees. Because our people love to hear the word, but they don't want to do. Read, come on.
And they come unto thee as the people cometh, and they sit before thee as my people.
You know you're the Israelites. You come and sit before God, but you don't act like the Israelites. Read, come on.
And they sit before thee as my people, and they hear thy words.
Right, like Pablo walked by with his children. He heard the word of God. Come on.
But they will not do them.
But guess what? All of you that are outside the nation of Israel, my delight will be in chains and iron. One day, we shall wreak vengeance upon your foremothers and forefathers. And that phony facade you put on, it shall be revealed for who you are. You are the scum of the earth. You Edomites will pay according to God. So keep trying to steal what was taken from us. Read, come on.
For with their mouth they show much love.
Pablo says, yeah, yo, I'm Pablo. I'm getting the kingdom. Yo, brother, Paul said we're all sinners. So with their mouth they act like they know God. You act like you know God, but go, come on.
But their heart goeth after their covetousness.
But their heart goes after their desire. The word covetous means one's desire. Like, for example, today is the Sabbath day. Many of you desire to buy something on the Sabbath. Did you know today was the seventh day? Did you know that black men and black women and the Israelites were not supposed to buy on the Sabbath? And guess what? The word of God is in your spirit now. You can act like you don't hear, but God's word will seal the 12,000 we tried.
Right.
And if you don't change, you're going to die. Right. Come on.
And lo, thou art unto them as a very lovely song of one that hath a pleasant voice and can play well on an instrument.
Because that's what the Israelites like. They like to hear the word of God, but they don't want to do the word of God. That's why they have things and institutions set up to lock us up, using other nations to serve their purpose to punish the 12 tribes. Why? Because we're disobedient. So now, let me ask you a question, brother. I see you perusing with your eyes the sign. Do you see anything on the sign that jumps out at you? He might be deaf. Let me carry on. Now, let's get the book of Isaiah 58, verse 1. If he's deaf, he might be deaf. I need to learn sign language. Come on. Isaiah 58, verse 1. Come on.
Isaiah chapter 58, verse 1. Cry aloud.
The Bible tells us and commands us as the prophets of the Lord to cry aloud. Meaning, no matter if any of you actually listen, the Bible says go out on the highways and cry aloud to his people. Come on.
Cry aloud. Spare not.
Don't spare their feelings. Like Pablo came in sincerely at first. But when Pablo left, he automatically went back to everything that he learned in America. So whether Pablo listens or not, it doesn't matter. Whether Fatima listens or not, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if anybody in this camp don't listen. God's word going to go forth no matter whether you like it or not. Read, come on.
Cry aloud, spare not, lift up thy voice like a trumpet.
A trumpet is a loud musical instrument that when it goes forth, it is very powerful. God said, cry aloud. Don't worry about how they feel. Tell them, thus saith the Lord. If they don't want to do it, the hell with them. Read, come on.
And show my people their transgression, and the house of Jacob their sins.
Let's give an example. Why is it that in the black community, we allow them to change laws that they put up initially in this country? And you parents, you walk by, you allow your grandchildren, you allow your neighbor, your nephew to go into these lifestyles, homosexual lifestyles, and you do not correct them. You allow it to happen. God's got a plan for you too. Read, come on.
Cry aloud, spare not, lift up thy voice like a trumpet, and show my people their transgressions.
The only way to show the Israelites their transgressions is by bringing forth the law. And most of you black and Hispanic men and women, you don't want to hear God's law. Read.
And the house of Jacob their sins.
Because we came from the loins of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Jacob became a nation. We are a part of a nation who has been divided through slavery and captivity. Now it is time for us as a people to come together like the captain brought out. One nation coming together in God's laws.
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to Join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC to stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.